Few studies have evaluated the use of clinical decision rules, or D-dimer, to diagnose pulmonary embolism in pregnancy. The YEARS criteria are used to evaluate suspected pulmonary embolism. They include three criteria to assess risk: clinical signs or symptoms of DVT, hemoptysis, and pulmonary embolism as the most likely diagnosis. On the basis of these criteria and their D-dimer result, patients may then undergo CT pulmonary angiography. In this multicenter international management study, 498 consecutive pregnant patients with suspected pulmonary embolism were assessed for D-dimer concentration and the YEARS criteria. Patients who met none of the criteria and had a D-dimer concentration of less than 1,000 nanograms per milliliter, or with one or more criteria and a D-dimer concentration of less than 500 nanograms per milliliter, were considered not to have pulmonary embolism. Of the remaining patients, in those with clinical signs of DVT, the YEARS criteria were adjusted for pregnancy to include compression ultrasound for DVT. In the absence of clinical signs of DVT or a negative ultrasound, CT pulmonary angiography was performed. The primary outcome was the incidence of venous thromboembolism in patients with initially normal tests during 3 months of follow-up. The key secondary outcome was the percentage of patients in whom CT pulmonary angiography was not indicated. With this approach, the primary outcome occurred in one patient who was diagnosed with popliteal DVT. No patient was diagnosed with pulmonary embolism. 39% of the patients were managed without CT angiography. Among the subgroup of women in the third trimester, 32% were managed without CT angiography. The authors conclude that the use of the pregnancy-adapted YEARS algorithm safely ruled out acute pulmonary embolism in pregnant patients referred for suspected pulmonary embolus. Full study results are available at NEJM.org.